Hello everyone. I'm Professor S.N. Male, Assistant Professor, Department of Processing and Food Engineering, working in KKVAG College of Agriculture Engineering and Technology, Nashik. Today we will learn about practical on study of wax coating. So we will see here wax coating in case of fruits as well as vegetables. So in the content we will see here introduction, then fruits benefited by waxing, then what are the different advantages or disadvantages of the waxing, then what are the different types of waxes, then which methods are used for waxing, then what is the actual working principle behind the waxing, then we will learn about the wax coating on the apples as well as the citrus. And at the finally, we will learn about the what is the conclusion of this process of waxing. So first of all, we will learn about the introduction about waxing. See, fruit waxing is nothing but a processing of the process of covering the fruits, and that covering it is done by the either natural wax or some artificial wax. Okay, most of the times fruits and vegetables, these are coated with some natural wax. Usually this wax, it is removed with the help of washing and some other waxing materials. It may be natural or some petroleum based, or it is called as artificial. This application of such a waxing material on the these commodities, it is called as a fruit waxing. Now, waxes are often mixed with the water or other wetting agents in order to ensure they are applied thinly and evenly to the outer surface of the product. External appearance, it is very important attribute for the overall fruit and for their quality. So various types of waxes and edible surface coatings, it may be applied to the fruits in order to improve the cosmetic features like their shine and color of their food product. Okay, then waxing, it is recommended only for the good quality products because it doesn't improve the quality of inferior ones. See here, waxing, it is mostly used for the good quality of the product, not for the inferior ones, because we can't improve the quality of that particular fruit or vegetable after harvesting. Okay, so there are number of preservation techniques, or we have to maintain just quality of that particular commodities by using different methods. So waxing is one of them. Here, which kind of fruits are get benefited by the waxing? See here, avocados, then lemon, grapes, banana, then melons, oranges, then lime, passion fruit, then peaches and pineapple. These commodities which get benefited by the waxing application. So we will see some advantages and disadvantages of waxing. First of all, its advantages. It is improves the appearance of the product, then it reduces the moisture loss, then less economic loss will be there. It reduces the post-harvest decaying, then prevents damage and diseases, then it replaces some natural wax, as well as increasing the freshness of the commodity, then decrease the rate of transpiration, longer post-harvest life we will get by this method, then less susceptibility to the chilling injury. So these are some of the advantages. Along with this waxing, it has certain disadvantages, like obviously we are applying some artificial or petroleum based waxes, so it gives the artificial appearance to the commodity. Then it adding the more cost due to the use of certain waxing material. Then sometimes surface burning may be there. Then wax whitening may be there. It means sometimes chalky surface of that commodity will be happen. Then off flavor development. Also along with this, there are another disadvantage is that there may be the chances to trap some chemical residues inside the that natural surface of our commodity and the while application of that waxing material. So during washing, sometimes these chemical residues, it doesn't get clean. In that condition, there may be the certain chances to remove such a kind of remain such a kind of chemical residues in between them. Okay, so that is the one of the disadvantages of the waxing. Now we will see what are the different types of vaccines. See here, it is classified into the animal vaccines, then vegetable vaccines, and the mineral or the synthetic vaccines. In the animal vaccine, there are certain vaccines in which bee vax, then spermaceti vax, and the shellac vax. Certain vaccines, these are obtained from the particular animals. Here, bee vax obtained from the honeybee, shellac vax obtained from the particular female bug, female shellac. Okay, then here vegetable waxes. In vegetable waxes, there are certain number of waxes are there: carnauba wax, candelilla wax, then sugarcane wax, palm wax, etc. Now this carnauba wax, these are obtained from the carnauba tree. Then candelilla wax, these are also obtained from the candelilla leaves. Means certain vegetable waxes obtained from a particular basically from the particular plant. Okay, then mineral based and synthetic waxes. Here these are certain waxes in which ozocerite, then montan wax, synthetic wax, and the polyethylene, these are obtained from the petroleum based waxes. Now we will see what are the different methods of waxing. See, first is method that is liquid paraffin wax method. In this method, certain fruits and vegetables are dipped into the hot paraffin, and sometimes resins are also added in that wax. Now, main disadvantages of this method is that there may be the chances of much of coating material may be there. Then next is the slab wax method or the roller brushing method. Now in this method, wax it is pressed against the rapidly revolving brushes. Okay, so the efficiency is very less. The third method is the spray method. Now in this method, spraying of the melted wax on the commodity it is takes place and subsequently brushed mechanically. Means while application of this spraying of wax on the fruit or any commodity, simultaneously we use some brush in order to for the application of uniform application of that waxy material. Okay, then the wax it is dissolved in a suitable solvent, which is depend upon the pressure employed, then volume of wax and the wax temperature. And also there is the distance of the fruit from that spray, it is also matters, and how many number of spray nozzles are used for the using such a method. Then next method is the dipping or cold wax method, here in which fruits and vegetables, these are initially washed and then without being dried, these are dipped into a wax emulsion of the proper concentration. And after that, they are dried before the packing. Now purified wax, it is the odorless, then tasteless and non-toxic, and it can be heat sealed. So these are some methods of the waxing application. Now these some pictures has shown here which kind of equipments are used for the mix, which kind of methods. Brushing rollers has been given here. Okay, now next we will see how wax acts. Okay, means actual what happens during the waxing, or certain improvements, or certain how the quality of that particular commodity can be maintained by the waxing. See here, all the fruits and vegetables, these are covered naturally in a cuticle, that is the barrier in order to moisture loss. Okay, however some water vapors, it can move through the pores, cuticle, and the micro cracks in the cuticle. During the process of waxing, a tightly adhering thin film of the coating substance, it is applied on the surface of the fruit. Now the wax coating, it blocks the pores in the cuticle, and significantly it reduces the amount of water vapor loss. See here, plant cell has shown here, cuticle layer has been given, then coating of the waxy layer, it is given here. See, micro cracks in the cuticles are there, then this is the epidermal cells and the flesh cells. This is the fleshy or pulpy portion. Okay, see the how the water loss or the oxygen loss, or the oxygen and the carbon dioxide exchange will be takes place. So once you apply this waxy layer, this kind of blocking may be takes place, and this interference or the exchange of these gases from atmosphere to the inner side of the material, or from inner side of material to the atmosphere, it will get blocked. Okay, see, before application of the vaccine, see how the exchange of gases takes place. But after application of vaccine, see this layer of the coating, it will prevent the entry of this number of gases from inside to outside, or from outside to inside of the commodity. Now the wax coating on apple, we will see. See here, the coating of apples, it is carried out by applying a thin layer of wax on the surface. Now this process, it is carried out by either, you can use any kind of method, that is by dipping, brushing, or the spraying with wax. Normally this coating, it is referred to as a edible coating. Okay, an edible coating, it is a thin layer that is applied on the surface of the fruits and vegetables, which is consumed together with the fruit. Now an apple with a good waxy coating, it will store better than one with a partial waxy coating or no waxy coating at all. Okay, as we know that this waxy coating to the apple, it can store your commodity for the longer period. The waxes applied on the apples, it can either be animal wax, vegetable wax, or the mineral based waxes. The most common type of waxes used for the apples, it is called as a carnauba wax or the shellac wax. So this is all about the waxing of apple. See here, which kind of equipment it is used, spraying of that, spraying method of the waxing it is used. See the waxed material and unwaxed material of the apple has shown here. Now what are the advantages and disadvantages of the waxing to the apples? First of all, advantages. Apples, it can apply the wax to improve the appearance and they increase the visual freshness. The main reason on are the either for preservation, then aesthetic purpose, or for the obvious of the replacing the natural wax. Okay, some of these are some reasons for applying the waxing. Now these apples are waxed in order to reduce the loss of water, hence ameliorating the wet loss, means also wet loss may be get reduced. Also it maintains the firmness and the freshness of the commodities. Then the distributor and the sellers of the apple, it can apply wax in order to improve the appearance and increase the visual freshness. Now disadvantages, see here, waxing apples, it can have some negative effects on the apple fruit. One of the effect is that anaerobic respiration, because there is no presence of oxygen, that's why it can occur in the fruit, since the wax may act as an oxygen barrier. Okay, so there is the unavailability of oxygen, that's why anaerobic respiration may be happen. Then the wax, it can be used to disguise the quality of apples. Sometimes some waxes are also used to disguise the quality of the apples. Waxed apples, it may look glossy, then slick, shiny, firm, and appealing, but they could be soggy and lacking the desirable crispy texture. Okay, when the wax is applied, then it will become their texture, it becomes soggy and it reduces the desirable crispy texture. So these are some disadvantages of coating on the apple. Now we will see some wax coating on the citrus. Citrus fruits are the juiciest among all the other fruits. So the waxing coating, it is wisely used on the citrus fruits. After production of citrus, cultivators or the wholesalers or the dealers and sellers, it adopt the use of different waxes for the waxing. Now it is applied by any kind of method, paraffin based coating or the dipping. Sorry, here wax, it is applied on the citrus only by the dipping. Paraffin based coatings are used to control the wet loss, while resin water solution containing the shellac, alkali resin, and emulsifiers are used for the longer shelf life and the better shine. Now there are certain advantages of this method, that is reducing the wet loss, then it maintains freshness, firmness, reduces the spoilage during transportation and the storage, enhances the original texture and the color of the fruit. Now at the finally, we will come to the conclusion, that is coating, it improves the product appearance, color, crispness, flavor, nutritive value, juiciness, and texture. This continuous mechanization is not available for the various coating operations. Safety of the food product, it should be maintained in the coating operations. Many of the coating materials are high in cost, and some of the coating operations are also higher in cost. This leads to increase in the cost of production or the cost of operation of the coating. So we have to reduce the cost of coatings. Coating, it can extend the shelf life and make the product available throughout the season. How? By delaying the ripening process, then delay the color changes, reduces weight loss, reduces then transpiration, it maintains texture and reduces the decay. So this is all about the study of waxing. In this lecture, we learned about the what is meant by wax coating, which kind of waxes are used for waxing, then which kind of methods are used for the waxing, then different wax coating on the apple and citrus we learned here. In this lecture, we learn about the waxing methods, then which kind of waxes are used for the waxing, then what is the actual principle behind the waxing, and what are their advantages and disadvantages. So thank you.